All right, happy flippin' Monday, and that little ditty thanks to HacksRadio.com, the place where the bass cannon is slapping and the FBI is fapping. Much love to the hackers and whackers. Shout out Mr. E, the fixer, Pride of Cause, the rest of the crew. It's time again, Hacker News. Good Lord. First up, Orion Browser Dumper version 1.0 has been released. Darkcoder SC, as he's known as, released another browser forensic tool for a community called Orion Browser Dumper version 1.0. The software is an advanced local browser history extractor. In less than a few seconds, it will extract the whole history content of most famous web browsers, Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Firefox, Google Chrome, Komodo Dragon, Rockmelt, and Opera. You can download the tool from the official website of Dark Comet. You'll find that link at thehackernews.com. Moving along, 17-year-old teenager arrested over team poison hacking attacks. He's been arrested on suspicion of being a member of Team Poison, a computer hacking group that has claimed responsibility for 1,400 offenses, including an attack on the phone system of Scotland Yard's counterterrorism unit last month. These include attacks on the United Nations, the UK anti-terrorist hotline, MI6, RIM, as well as politicians including Nicolas Sarkozy and Tony Blair. The boy who police suspect used the hacker nickname MLT was a spokesman for Team Poison, was interviewed at a local police station on offenses under the Computer Misuse Act on Wednesday. The arrest is part of an ongoing investigation by the police Central E-Crime Unit, division of the Metropolitan Police, into various hacking gangs who have made headlines in the last year or so. Team Poison's highest profile attack was mounted against Scotland Yard's counter-terror hotline last month, has also claimed responsibility for distributed denial of service attacks against banks in collaboration with Anonymous, another hacktivist group which is similar anti-corporate, anti-authority policies. Moving along, Pentagon still playing their games. Pentagon Boost Contractor Cybersecurity Program. The U.S. Defense Department invited all of its eligible contractors on Friday to join a previously restricted information sharing pact aimed at guarding sensitive Pentagon program data stored on private computer networks. What I want to know is, why the fuck is Pentagon information on private computer networks? Anyway, moving along, back to the story. Pentagon predicts that as many as 1,000 defense contractors may join a voluntary effort to share classified information on cyber threats under an expansion of a first-ever initiative to protect computer networks. The effort, known as the Defense Industrial Base, or DIB, program, is a voluntary information sharing program in which the Department of Defense shares unclassified indicators and related classified contextual information about cyber attacks and threats with defense contractors. In exchange, defense contractors report known intrusions and can receive forensics analysis and damage assessments from the government after those attacks. In an optional part of the program, the DIB enhanced cybersecurity services, the government shares additional classified threat and technical data with the defense contractors and internet security providers. If the Pentagon's effort proves successful in safeguarding defense contractors from cyber attacks, good luck with that. The administration may enlarge the program to companies in 15 other critical infrastructure categories through the Department of Homeland Security. More than 2,000 companies qualify, and the membership roles will be expanded on a first-come, first-served basis. The official said, at the Pentagon entry level, the Pentagon will give participants unclassified indicators and classified contextual information, as well as suggested measures for addressing cyber threats. Volunteer companies must sign up a standardized bilateral framework pact that calls for sharing to the greatest extent possible for the clearest understanding of cyber threats, according to an interim final rule published Friday in the Federal Register. You can read that via thehackernews.com. And Hacker Conference 2012. This is big stuff, and the Hacker News reporting they're extremely excited to announce a call for papers for the conference. You can get information about that conference, which will be held in New Delhi, India. It opens May 1st, first round of speakers online June 1st, CFP closing date is July 1st, final speakers list online is the 10th of July, and the conference date is the 29th of July 2010. So, something good to look into. Moving along, cyber attacks on gas pipeline linked to China. The spear phishing attacks laying siege to networks in the natural gas pipeline industry apparently are being carried out by the same group that hacked RSA security last year. The attacks have been occurring since late this past March and have targeted several of the country's natural gas pipeline companies. According to U.S. officials, it is unclear if a foreign power is trying to map the gas system or if hackers are attempting to harm the pipelines. A previous attack on oil and gas sector seemed to originate in China. DHS supplied the pipeline industry and its security experts with digital signatures or indicators of compromise. Those indicators include computer file names, computer IP addresses, domain names, and other key information associated with the cyber spies, which companies could use to check their networks for signs that they have been infiltrated. DHS officials and a spokesman have acknowledged they are working with the FBI to find out who may be behind the intrusion and malicious emails. The Monitor reports that some investigators now believe the campaign is tied to another attack last year against cybersecurity company RSA, which the head of the National Security Agency told Congress would be traced back to China. And last but not least, Bitcoin has been hacked, more than 18,000 Bitcoin stolen. Bitcoinia, a Bitcoin exchange started by 17-year-old teenager Zhu Tong, has been shut down for security investigations. It's believed that at least 18,000 BTC have been stolen. News of the hack was posted just this morning by Bitcoin's founder. This was actually be Friday morning. Today we have discovered a suspicious Bitcoin transaction that doesn't seem to be initiated by anyone of the company owners. Some of them are not online at the moment. And this is not conclusive. So you can check out that information as well at thehackernews.com. That brings you up to date, and I will see you again on Wednesday. Much love, be safe, and keep doing what you do.